caught in the trap. I can't walk out because I love you too much, baby. Why can't you see what you're doing to me when you don't believe a word I'm saying?
Word I'm saying.
We can't go on together with suspicious minds, and we can build our dreams on suspicious minds. So if an old friend I know stop by and say hello, would I still see suspicion in your eyes? Here we go again, asking where I've been. You can't see these tears are real, I'm crying.
Tears I'm crying.
We can't go on together with suspicious minds.
With suspicious minds.
We can't build our dreams on suspicious minds. Don't let our love survive. Don't dry these tears from your eyes. Don't let a good thing die. No, honey, you know I would never lie to you. Yeah, yeah. We're caught in a trap. I can't walk out. Because I love you too much, baby. Why can't you see what you're doing to me when you don't believe a word I'm saying?
Word I'm saying.
We can't go on together. Suspicious
mind, and we can build our
dream on suspicious minds.
So who is Abraham?
Oh, how exciting that we've actually gone through. I counted the tracks, Cinnamon. We went through 11 tracks of the intro. So this is so far an 11 show series.
Woo!
Actually doing all of the introduction to Abraham. This is the first time that I've ever done this, and I'm so excited about it. And here we come circling back around to the first track where Abraham is. Please, Cinnamon. No need to cover.
Yes.
Back around to the first track where Abraham is coming and saying, hey, this is who we are, introducing ourselves, which I think is so cool. And really love some of the topics in here. Very insightful and helpful. So, do you have a passage you'd like to share? Because I would love to hear it. I'm so excited to talk about it.
Okay. Who is Abraham? Abraham is understanding this is an introduction of non-physical to physical.
Okay. Come on.
Let's start that. So this Abraham is introducing themselves non-physical to physical.
Pretty cool introduction.
They are now completing an intention that has been set forth long before most of us who are now physical were in these physical bodies. So way back when.
Right.
A long, long time ago. An agreement whereby they said they would remain there focused through broader, more powerful, non-physical perspective, while I will go forth into these magnificent physical bodies. And together, through communication, we will co-create. Abraham is wanting most of all for those who are physical beings to understand the magnificence of our being. We're magnificent, Mayor.
Come on.
They are wanting me to understand who I am and why I have come forth into this physical dimension.
Nice.
There are many of them there in the non-physical dimension gathered around of identical intent or wanting. And they are offering themselves with the name of Abraham because they are wanting me to think of them as teachers.
Nice.
Right?
So
fun. Teacher, meaning one who is currently broader in understanding.
Nice.
That's a good definition. I enjoy that. Right? Who may offer words or stimulation of thought. I like that too. That through the laws of the universe, I may attract unto me knowledge. That's beautiful.
Right?
Who may offer words of stimulation of thought.
Yeah.
That through the laws of the universe, I may attract unto me knowledge.
What a cool definition of teacher.
Yes.
A teacher is broader in understanding and offers words which stimulate thought. And then the thought attracts the experience and the experience brings the knowledge. I find that fascinating.
Bravo. It sounds like you understand.
Okay. When
you can explain it simply.
Cinnamon, you're funny.
It's true. That was clear.
Okay, good.
That was very clear.
Cinnamon. That's funny.
So they learned a long time ago, words do not teach.
Right? That's funny.
That's a broader perspective. But words do stimulate thought, and thought is attractive. Yeah. All thoughts are powerful magnets, attracting more of same unto me.
Yes.
It is their knowing that through their word, stimulate my thought or my awareness or my wanting that they may guide me to expanded knowingness.
Nice.
Like I've chosen some things before. I guess I chose total awareness. So that seems like that's it.
Yeah, right. Expanded knowingness. I like it.
Yeah. And that is the point of all of this.
Expanded knowingness. Well, yeah. That's what we are doing. My knowing,
stimulating my thoughts and my awareness and my wanting that they're guiding me. So I have these thoughts.
Yeah.
And so now the non-physical is guiding me towards stimulations of my thoughts and awarenesses, guiding me towards the expanded knowingness of who I am.
Right. I listen to your funny. You're very
expanded
cute.
Expanded knowingness.
I like how they say that as we understand who they are, yeah, we'll understand who we are.
Yes.
They're saying we're going to start by introducing ourselves. I think that's interesting. We're saying we want you to know who you are and why you're here, which I really would like to know. I feel like when I have an understanding of why I'm here, the more I'm aware of why I'm here, which is an ever expanding concept, but the more I'm thinking about that, the better my life is. Cause I'm even considering I'm actually here for a purpose. I'm here for a reason. And I chose to come, which changes the dynamic of my life completely changes when I say, okay, I'm here. I chose to be here. And I love Abraham saying, we want you to know who we are. And as you know who we are, you'll understand who you are. And we are a teacher. Which is so cool. I love this definition of teacher. And I found it fascinating that they said, you know, that in the law of attraction track, it says, I am a magnet. You are a magnet attracting unto you. Okay. Now they also said in this track, they say, all thoughts are magnets attracting more of same unto them. So what I'm deducing here is I am thought. Thought is magnet attracting more of same. I am magnet attracting more of same. I am thought. I think that's interesting.
That's profound there.
Which cinnamon, which once again is expanded knowingness, is they're saying.
Yes.
That's the point.
Yeah.
as I'm listening to the audio, as I'm writing it down, passaging it, now thoughts being stimulated, and that thought is attracting experience. And it's interesting to see the timeline of this and like my life and the experiences I'm having as we're doing this introduction to Abraham, because
yeah,
experiences are helping me to understand what's being said in here.
Mm-hmm.
Yet yes, these words are so very helpful because they stimulate thought.
Yeah.
Really cool. So we have 7 more minutes left of this initial track before we have completed Abraham's section of the introduction to Abraham, which is pretty exciting. Actually passaging the entire introduction to Abraham, Abraham's part. That's like a trophy, I feel like.
And now I'm beginning to understand.
Right. Right.
Wrote the whole thing, and now I'm starting to catch on a little bit.
Right, right, right. It's true.
But it's worth it.
It is.
Worth it. For expanded knowingness, come on.
I'm spending time anyway. What else am I doing?
Yeah.
It's the best part of my day.
And today, for me, was what I totally relate to yesterday's call, because I was happy this morning, and then I had a meeting. And I still was happy going into that meeting. And they're like, how are you doing today? I'm like, fantastic. They're like, even though you're here? And I'm like, yeah, I plan on getting some good news. And it didn't go that way.
Oh.
And I just wanted to cry.
Right. Was... right.
But then when I got home, I started writing the passages and everything changed.
Right.
I started it last night, but I picked right back up where I was today. And then I started feeling better.
Nice.
And remembering that my thoughts matter.
Right.
I'm a magnet drawing unto me. How long would I stay with that? Obviously, I'm looking at it wrong, because that's why it feels so horrific. That's not how it goes. That's not how Abraham's looking at it. That's not how non-physical sees it. And that's why it hurts. Why don't you change the way that you're looking at it?
Right. Good point.
Okay. Twist it to me.
Right.
And it helps to remember the laws.
Yeah.
Or it's just off and running.
Right. Good point. Good name for the show, off and running. Getting it tamed. You know, the mind.
And then I thought of you today, Mary. It rained.
Yeah.
Like, okay. It rains here. So I'm out exercising and it starts raining.
Oh,
and
my. It,
amazing.
Right?
So I started running.
Like, all right.
I wouldn't say running, okay, jogging, but it was fun. And I usually go, and it was like I was flying. It was Woo. It was so cool. Like, way long, everyone. I'm like, Mary would love this. This is so fun.
That's great. I love running in the rain.
Desert rain.
Right. It's really the best. It has that aroma.
Yes.
A unique scent.
And then when I got home, the sun came out.
Of course it did.
It was beautiful.
Of course it did.
All right. So even though I'm not here, I'm thinking of you. And my thoughts are creative.
Right?
We're in Holy Trinity.
Yes. Indeed we are. And I'm so grateful for it. It's altering my existence. I could feel today, you know, I woke up today. You know, the whole plan of me, I wanted to just wake up today and start. And the coach was there to say, well, you're going to start from where you are right now, do the show, get yourself in a better position, then go to sleep, then get up. And so I woke up today feeling the effect of that. And
yes.
I know, I'm so grateful for it, because I've had such a better day today because of getting, you know, because it happened to me the day before too, where I was like, I can't do this today. And I had every reason in the world not to, but then I still stayed the next day in that not really good space. So today I woke up and I was feeling so much better, and I've had such a better day today. And it's all thanks to our show, tuning me in, giving me a reason to sit there and write the passages and have a reason to be good is really helpful. You would think knowing law of attraction would be enough reason. And that's the point of the show. Is to know law of attraction so that I know that this is my reason to be good, because there's a camera on me all the time. Law of attraction is on, right? This camera goes on and I'm like smiling, you know, smile, camera's on. Well, it's always on is what I'm talking to. So I appreciate our coming together here. I feel the power of it. And I'm so excited that we are so close to actually finishing the Introduction to Abraham. It's going to be a playlist all on its own, an Introduction to Abraham playlist of all these shows on the Introduction to Abraham. You'll find that in the playlist on Hope Skyrockets. And it'll be like it's like a study guide. You're like my study buddy, Cinnamon. And thank you for being my study buddy.
Thank you, Mare, and way to go. Wonderful job on the thumbnails, on the videos.
All right.
And editing and the behind the scenes.
Yeah.
I still love all of that. And I really appreciate you doing that. You do a fantastic job. It's so professional and well done.
It's my pleasure. I really love it.
When a video comes out, I was like, oh, I can't wait to see what the thumbnail is. What did she do?
All right. Nice.
That's I wonder what this one's going to be.
Something good
for sure, always.
All right, people, well, until next time, which you know will be tomorrow probably. that is my plan, at least. And Cinnamon's awesome. She's the greatest teammate. So I'm like, are you in? She's like, yes. She doesn't ever cancel. I'm the canceler. No more though. I am the instigator. I am the one who says, let's do this. I am the great teammate. Thought
we're worth it. Mare. We're worth doing the passages and coming together and smiling for
right? 10 minutes. Right?
It and reminding each other what we're doing here and how it goes.
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
I'm grateful.
Me too, Cinnamon.
Remember, love is the answer. Stay tuned.